The real estate industry is the world's single largest contributor to climate change. At Fifth Wall, we're on a mission to help the industry eradicate its carbon emissions and build to zero.
Kathy, thank you so much for joining. Where are you coming in from today?
I'm calling in from San Carlos, California.
Nice. Well, can you start maybe by just giving your background and kind of the arc of your career leading up to starting Dandelion?
Absolutely. So I studied civil engineering in school and then got master's degree in computer science and really wanted to use that to do something in energy. I ended up working at Google and eventually made my way over to Google X as a product manager who was responsible for coming up with new ideas and businesses for X to start. And that work eventually led me to geothermal heat pumps. And I ended up spinning out that work as a company called Dandelion.
And can you just talk about that, you know, that inspiration, obviously, from Google X. Like, what was it there that led to, you know, founding Dandelion Energy?
Absolutely. A lot of our mandate as people trying to find new projects for X to pursue was, you know, you have to find something that's a big enough opportunity for Google to actually care, which is actually a very high bar, given how big Google is. We also needed it to be technology centric. And then lastly, it's an idealistic place. So the goal was to make the businesses we were starting something very useful for society. And that actually seemed to align really well with energy, in my opinion, because we have such big energy problems today with climate change. The market is gigantic, and a lot of the solutions, though not all, are technology focused. So my purview is really trying to find what can we do in energy that meets those criteria. I never would have imagined that would take me to geothermal heat pumps, but what really captured my attention is it turns out that especially in cold climates like the East Coast or the Midwest, 80% plus of energy used in buildings goes towards heating and cooling. If you replaced all of those heating systems with geothermal heat pumps, not only would you eliminate all of those emissions, you would also save people an incredible amount of money.
For people that just aren't as familiar with what geothermal heating and cooling is or means practically, what is it? Can you kind of explain it in simplistic terms to people?
Absolutely, yeah. So let me just start out by saying the two major components of a geothermal heating and cooling system are these things that are called ground loops, which are just simple plastic pipes buried in a yard. You can do it in a lot of different ways, but we tend to do one or two of them that are 300 to 500 feet deep and just vertical. So they're quite deep, but they're only an inch and a quarter in diameter. So think small, thin, long, deep pipes. They're just circulating water with an antifreeze in it. So that's one part. The other part of the system is the heat pump. And this is, it kind of looks like a furnace, to be honest. And it's where your furnace would be otherwise connected to the ductwork in the building and connected to these ground loops that are outside. And what that heat pump is doing is it's circulating water through the ground loops. And as that water travels through the ground, it comes to, you know, it exchanges heat with the ground just passively. It, you know, if you put water into those pipes, it will eventually come to the temperature that the ground is. And then that water goes into the heat pump, and that heat pump extracts that heat from the water and boosts the temperature and then distribute it throughout your house. And it can work in reverse too. So you can also take heat out of your house and put it into this water so it dissipates into the ground. So it's actually quite simple.
From a household perspective, like what are the actual savings?
Yeah. So for our customers in New York, and we're really focused on the Northeast, a typical customer will be spending $3,000 to $4,000 on fuel oil to heat their house in a given year in New York. And if they switch to geothermal, they're going to pay about $1,000 on the electricity to run their geothermal heat pump. So it's a significant savings.
If an asset were powered by clean energy sources, such as solar, since geothermal heat pumps only require energy to operate, you could actually truly run a fossil fuel-less heating or cooling system at an asset level. Is that right?
That's exactly right. And a lot of our customers do have solar on their roofs that they can use to run their heat pumps, and then they're completely net zero. But we also offer to our customers the option to sign up for community solar. So even if they don't have solar on their roof and can't get it because of shading or don't want to get it, it's a great option because community solar costs about 10% less than grid electricity. And because your cost of doing geothermal heating and cooling is directly proportional to what you pay for electricity, it makes your cost of heating and cooling 10% less to sign up for community solar. So Dandelion is just all about trying to find those ways to align the customer's financial incentives with decarbonization.
What's the life, like what's the usable life of a geothermal heating system, like for an asset?
Yeah, this is one of my favorite things about geothermal heating and cooling systems. So I'm glad you asked. Those ground loops, which are really the things that differentiate geothermal, they last as long as the building itself. So they're warrantied for 50 years, but they will last. I mean, they're just inert HDPE plastic pipes encased in grout buried in the ground. So they're not going anywhere. They're just going to last. The indoor equipment, it lasts for 20 to 25 years. And so when you got to 25 years, you would probably just replace the heat pump inside the house. But that's a very simple thing to do. It's like replacing an air conditioner. So one of the things that I find very satisfying about the work is just when we put ground loops next to a house, that house will use renewable heating forever. I mean, there's no reason financially that it would ever go back. So it's like each time we transition a building away from fossil fuel heating, it's transitioned.